Solvete omnes. Today we're looking at interrogative pronouns. All right, interrogative pronouns, we've always seen a little bit in the singular here, quis and quid. Now you say, what's an interrogative pronoun? Well, it's what. So when you're asking, it's a pronoun, so it goes in place of a noun and asks a question. So for example, if you say, quid est, what is it? Quid nomen tibi, what is your name? Quid agis, how are you doing? Quis est, who are you? Things like that. These are the question words, and they're very similar to qui, quid, quo. So go ahead and put these down in your composition notebook, please. And you'll see this is the singular forms, and you'll notice there's a masculine and feminine are the same. So it's quis, quid, cuius, cuius, qui, quem, quid, quo, quo. And then plural is just like qui, quid, quo in the plural. Qui, quid, quid, quorum, 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 quibus, 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 quos, quas, qui, quibus, quibus, quibus. And the question people always ask me, well, how do you translate? Well, how do you translate? Is this like how you translate qui, quid, quo with a little variation? So I put this down right now. It means quis and quid, or qui, quid, quo, or qui, quid, quo, sorry, means who or what. Cuius is the genitive form, so that would make it mean whose. Cui would mean to whom. Or to what, and same thing for the plural. Quem and quid would mean whom or what, and the ablative would be with whom, by whom, from whom, etc., or by what. All right, and then the way you use an interrogative pronoun. Let's go ahead. If I would stop the video here, if you want to make sure you have it all down. All right, because I'm going to erase it. I'm erasing it. You need to go back. All right, now the way you use it in a sentence here is just, I'll write this out. We can do a couple here. We say, classic one, quis, s. And you'll notice that it differs from qui, qui, quo. First, the question word is first in the sentence. Word, first. Also, another thing you'll notice that it's in the main part of the sentence. Main part, or the independent clause. This is a sentence. Quid spectas. What are you looking at? Okay. Now, if you're going to use it with cu, you say, you would go quo cum. Navi ga visti. With whom do you sail? Did you sail? Now, as the main part, also you'll notice there is no nay. You don't need nay to ask a question with quis or quid, both in single and plural. And you say, well, how does it work in the plural? So you can say it like this. But if it's a group of people, quos amas, whom do you like? Like, is there a group of people you like? All right. And things like that. Quibus pecuniam das. To whom did you give the money? Which group of people did you give the money? All right? So it's a question word, main part. It's the main part of the sentence. There's no nay. And you'll see it. And there we go. And that's an interrogative pronouns. All right. If you have questions, please talk to me in class. Valete omnes lingua latina est vita.